Hi friends, welcome to my channel Tech Plugin. So hey friends, today our subject is what is the WordPress. Many of you thinking about what is the WordPress, what is CMS, how we install and set up the WordPress, how WordPress help us to build a website, what is the history of WordPress, how it beneficial to us. So in this video guys, you get your all questions answer. So let's start it, Tech Plugin. So first thing is the WordPress is a free and open source content management system which is we call CMS based on the PHP and MySQL. Mike Little and Matt Wulong took over the development and end up the co-foundation of the WordPress platform. WordPress 0.7 was born in May 2003. In later years, it was followed by update version that include the theme system, persistent caching, and better widgets. By 2016, WordPress 4.5 Coleman. Here, guys, I'm explaining you what is the Coleman. So, the version 4.5 of the WordPress. The name is the Coleman in honor of a jazz saxophonist, the Coleman Hawkins, is available for download or the update in your means the WordPress dashboard. So, which facility they are provide, it's here, which added inline links, new formatting shortcuts, live responsive previews, and custom logos in a customizer functions. In the most widely used CMS software in the world, as end of May 2019, it power more than the 30% of the top 10 million website and has an estimated 60% of a market share of all website built using a CMS. WordPress start a simple blogging system in 2003, but it has evolved into a full CMS with a thousand of plugin, widgets and themes. It is a license under the general public license, which we call guys GPL. Nowadays, means a GPL version 2 or a greater version, it's required for your system. The GPL is the most important thing of a website because of you see in every theme or every purchase plugin or the free plugin, the GPL license is always there. If the plugin you buy from the null website or you get from the null plugin, it is dangerous to our website because it gathered our data or also it's harm our website by the virus or anything else. So make sure you are any plugin or any theme, it's always a GPL website, GPL license. So what is the requirements for the server sites? First thing, to run the WordPress, we recommend your host support the following. First, PHP version 7.3 or the greater. Second, MySQL version 5.6 or MariaDB version 10.1 plus. So HTTP support is required, guys. HTTP means secure hypertrans transfer protocol, which is the main thing of our website. It's provided by you as a SEL, which gives you the any hosting servers. Because of this, the Google is always show your website. If it's not there or it's not available, then it's always show that your website is not fitted for the user system. So make sure your any website is always the HTTPS support or okay. Let's see another point. On April 29, 2020, WordPress 5.4.1 was released to the public. This is the latest version of the WordPress till now. Okay, let's see what is the requirement for our local. First thing guys, the login account, which is a user ID and your password to the server via FTP and shell, because the user ID and password, it's always the secure. Okay, FTP means here guys, the file transfer protocol, which here we save our all the sites and we all the site files, and we always make the different changes on that file. And another is the text editor, guys. Text editor here help us to Making the changes on the code, like when you built a website and you want to change in a header or a footer. Not every theme give you the support to make their builder, or in a builder you change this. I think so. Divi gives you these access to change this text editor, or you don't need to go to the text editor and add your head code or add your footer code or any JavaScript and another and all these things. You don't need to here, but of many of the themes, you need to the text editor to change it, make changes on their templates. So here I'm also say you that the FTP, which is the file transfer protocol, is important. And here your web browser of a choice means you have many choice like a Chrome, Firefox and Opera, but I'm highly recommended to you to choose a Chrome because of the Chrome it is a feature of the Google. And also guys, it's not take too much time to load, so yeah, it's best. Okay, let's see what's other. It is the hosting for the WordPress. Here you see all the hosting lists, their start cost, their money back guarantee, their load time, their uptime and their ratings also. So in the first, I'm always using the Bluehost for the WordPress and other things. Because of Bluehost, it is simple to do your changes and simple to means get a domain, create a subdomain. You always get notified about your when the means their expiry dates. Also, they notified you all the things. If I in any error in occur your site, then they mail us. And I'm personally using the Bluehost. You using any of these? Okay, the first one is a Bluehost, and its the starting cost is 2.75. This is a monthly charge. The money back is 30 days. The loading time is 390. Here the milliseconds. The uptime is less than 19.99%, and their rating is always 5. So another is the HostGator Manage WordPress. Here the 3.99 monthly charge, the 45 days, the 369 milliseconds, the less than 99.99. Here also get the 5 star. Another the Hostinger, then the SiteGround is then the A2 Hosting, then Green Greeks, the DreamHost, the InMotion, the Site5 WordPress Hosting, the iPage. Here the all the list of this. And the loading time is here. You see the money back guarantee here. See, the best thing is the A2 Hosting is give you money at any time you want. Okay, and the start cost, the uptime, the ratings you see here. So let's see another. So let's see the comparison of a WordPress to other CMS platform in 2017-18. Guys, there are the many CMS platforms like Magento, Joomla, Drupal, and also OpenCart, PetraShop, and many more. But you ever see that WordPress is high chance, or they have the 90% of the website are made from the WordPress, where the Magento is now currently 4.6, the Joomla is a 4.3, and the Drupal is a 3.7. As you see the 2017, it is on the gray color. So you see here that it is 83%, and the 2018 it is 90%, and the all are the in a less form. Like 2017 or 2018, you take the Magento, Joomla, Drupal are not working like WordPress. So here comparison of a WordPress platform in 2018. Now here you see all the CMS platforms like WordPress, Magento, Joomla, Drupal, Modex, PetraShop, OpenCart and the others. But here also you see that it's 90% and all are the just 4.6, 4.3, 3.7, 0.9. And go through. So let's see how install and set up the WordPress. The first thing, download and install the WAM64 or the XAMPP to your server for the localhost. Guys, here the WAM64 or the XAMPP is used for your the localhost only when you want to create your site. First, I mentioned here that first you try to make your site on a localhost, not directly go to the domains. Because of that, you make the changes easily and you learn more about your site. because of going to domain, so you want to change, if any change in the file or anything, you want to go to your server, your host server, you want to open your file and do all the changes. So here you don't need, here only the file in your computer, just change it how you want to made it. Also the our website also safe, and make sure you take always means I'm saying monthly, just take a monthly backup for your website. So if it's any crash or get any problem in this, you just deleted the previously version and you put your backup and your site is working really fine. So let's see. Here I am telling you WAMP64 and XAMPP. Here also the one thing is a WAMP.net, which I am showing you the video for this their setup. Also I am providing the setup for the WAMP64 also and the XAMPP. So make sure you first do the on this local host. Second is download WordPress. So first thing guys, I mentioned all these links in my description box, so go there and download what you want. Okay, let's see. Then here you see to go the program files in a C drive where the WAMP64 is located. In my case guys, here you see in my case it's located in E, but I'm personally tell you that please make sure you install this on the E, install this in a C, not for the E, because PHP, which is required to run this, or the which is Apache server, MySQL server, which is required. This all the systems are conduct in our C disk, not in a E disk. So it makes sometimes problems to you. So guys, I'm personally tell you to go to the C drive, not for the E drive or any drive. So here you see the WAMP64 server is created when you just set up this. Then after, just create a new folder for your program. Like here I'm creating the SD. Then paste the WordPress zip and extract here. Here you see I'm the download the zip in this the SD folder, and I am extract this in the WordPress. So then start the WAMP server. For this starting the WAMP server, make sure you go to on a right corner, right hand bottom corner, and you see the WAMP icon. Just click this, just left click this, and select to the start option. First thing, it goes for the red, then it's go for the orange, and then it's come to the green. If this not working, or it's just stopping your orange color, for this error also I am sharing the video. So guys, stay tuned. So here you see this is the WAMP server or WAMP server dashboard. In the upper means when you click on the icon, the first you see the localhost. So this is the view of this the localhost. So here you see the your server configuration, also the your app page version, your server software, your PHP version, and also the tools, your projects, your LS, and your virtual host, which is the local host. So guys, here you for the opening your project, here you not write for HTTPS or the www, because we do the work in a local host. So you make sure you write first the local host slash your project name slash. After you write this project, you see this type of the pop-up or this type of the screen where you see the parent directory, the WordPress zip, and the WordPress folder. So for the setup, click on the WordPress folder. So because of you want to do the further setting, so make sure first you create the database for this. So go to the PHP MyAdmin. When you click on the icon, you see the PHP MyAdmin. Just click there, choose what where you want to do, like a MySQL or MariaDB, the both are used for the database guys. So choose this, write a root and click on the next. So the the dashboard of the PHP is open. Click on the new and then create the database. Here I'm giving the SD name for the database, and select UTF General CA and click on the create. Then come to the your WordPress where you means you extract where you will save. So here the ST is my working, and the WordPress, this is my the file. In this file you see here the WP configuration sample file. Just copy this, paste it there, and rename this wp.config. Here guys, this is the view of this the config file. So here you see the database name which you see there, and the database name is here, the db user, the username is here, the password. So first thing, make sure the database name which is you give, like I'm giving here SD, so I'm providing the SD. So the database user is root. If you want to means to change it, or if you want to give password, then I'm also provided this thing also. So just check this. Okay, so the database name is SD, the DB username is root, the password I'm not giving here password, so I'm leave it blank. Okay, our DB host is always local host, so don't change for this. So DB character is UTF-8 and write MB4. Okay, and just save this file. Okay, after that you get when you click on the WordPress and this all things done, then WP config file is detect. Okay, after the WP config file is detect, they give you the option to installing the WordPress. Click on the installing the WordPress, and here you see this type of option. Choose your language and click on let's go. Okay, see here. Here you see this type of pop-up where you write your database name which is SD. Here the your username which is root, leave it blank. Then database host, it is your local host, which you make a changes on the WP config file, write the same as it here. And here you see, click on the or run the installation, or click on the installation. So here fill the like a site title, your username. Here see in this image you see that site title I'm giving here the SD. You give any site title which or the subject of your website, like it is a consultant, or it is for the hotel website, or it is for the education website. Anything you want to give here, you just give your name of the your website. Then here we provide the username and password. Here we not provide the our database password or our database username. Here we provide the username and password to secure our site. So here I'm giving the admin for the username. Here I'm giving the password, and make sure you write your email ID, because of you giving here the email ID, if any problem occurs in future of your with your website, so they mail you about this is error, this is the problem, and you can go and you solve this and click on the WordPress. First thing guys, don't make a change any in the search engine visibility. This type of pop-up or this type of page you see, which is the success message is conducting, and the username is admin, and the password you want to write here. So make sure you write the accurate password. So for this, click on the login. Okay, first thing, enter your username, and also enter your password. And after that, you see your dashboard is open. This is the dashboard. Here guys, you see the dashboard option, the post, media option, the pages, the comments, the appearance, where you change your here you change your coding, also your widget, your footer, your menu you selected, and much more. Also here the plugins, and I'm telling about you the plugins and themes also. Here you set your users, the tools, the settings, and many more option on the WordPress dashboard. Okay, First thing is the theme. For the website, WordPress provide you the themes option. That's all free, guys. Some are the free and some are the paid. If you want to fully customize theme, then it's a paid. And if you want a basic theme for your site, so it is a free. I'm just saying you, if you the new user, if you just want to learn what is the means how we use the WordPress, so go for the free option, not for the paid option, because after you learning all the things about the means the payment, the contacts and the membership and all the things, have the WooCommerce also, so after learning of these all things, then you come for the paid themes. Before this, just use the free themes. Though here WordPress provide you the 7,466 free themes, guys. Okay, if you want to fully feature themes, then you buy the theme for a particular website. Here I'm also saying you, if you want the fully featured themes, then you want to buy the themes for the particular website, like the DV, many more options are there. Okay, you choose anything. This is a view of the themes, guys. This all the free. Just click on this anything you want to, then click on the install and click on the activate, and your theme is activated for your website. So next is plugin. So WordPress provide plugins that help you to improve your website by providing custom features. Okay, WordPress provide you 56,738 plugins. For example, payment gateway, forms, builders, and like link told you before this. The WordPress provide the many features, guys. You don't need to do any coding or any stuff like this. Just putting as your requirement, like plugin and theme, and yes, your site is made easily. Because of this, guys. This also provide the builders also to make your website fully customizable, fully responsive, so it helps you to more like a builder, like Elementor is also one builder, then the WP Bakery is the second, the DB Builder is also there. Okay, let's see another. This is the image. Here you see the four plugins. Just select as your requirement, just click on the plugin, then here you see the option. You want to install it, then click on the install and then click on the activate, and this plugin is activate for you. Make some changes on their setting and it's fully customizable to customize for your website. Okay, first thing, let's see what is the benefits here. So first is simple and use. This quality help WordPress overcome competitors like Drupal or Joomla and become the favorite choice of a web developer, everything eliminating the need of a master HTML, CSS, PHP and other complement technology. You don't have a deal with a coding if you don't want. If you change like a CSS for the any requirements, so you do this. Or if you give the any facility which is required, the JavaScript, much of this required for the JavaScript, then you also you provide the JavaScript. Also for the header and footer, the plugin available to insert this. Okay, let's see the second. Stable and innovative. Similar to your phone, WordPress stay up to date with the latest technology trends and user needs. The function and purpose of the website can change over time, and thankful WordPress is up to task. Okay, regular update means the CMS stays relevant, problem are solved, and the new useful existing features are added regularly. So third is the attractive design option. Let's see. WordPress come with a thousand of dedicated themes, many of them free, allowing you to customize and personalize your creation as your wish. Next is flexibility. You can choose around the 56,000 plus plugins and thousand of themes in order to give your the website a new look or adapt it to the consultant changing trends in an online site. It's also the best thing here is the WordPress is help to grow you are a search engine which is called the SEO. It is for the ranking on the Google's means it is ranking on the Google, which is the page ranker. Also the WordPress provide these plugins, so because of this your website is come closer to rank the Google. Here the search engine optimization, I'm tell you the part means before, the WordPress make the SEO a piece of a cake simply to use the h1 h2 and h3 tags. The use of a keywords, the words we insert in this, they are called the keywords. These keywords in your website URL and the supporting plugins like SEO means SEO Ultimate or all-in-one SEO SEO pack, Yoast SEO or Platinum SEO pack, and WordPress SEO, and many more plugins are available for your SEO. So let's see another. There is a structure. One of the feature that makes WordPress SEO ready is it a structure. The clean structure website load faster and the fast loading website appeal to a visitor. Then WordPress allow to creation XML sitemap. This is a help you to or this is a help to means show your website all the pages. If your website connected to the subdomain, then also they show the all the subdomain pages and your pages also. So I'm telling you how to see your XML and how to set up your SEO for your website. Also I'm show you the how we create a simple website by using all the free plugins, and also I'm giving the information about all the plugins and all the themes and many more facilities, guys. Okay, then let's see another. Easy content and management. Managing content has never been easier, and you can simplify things even more by assigning editors, authors, administrators, and limiting their freedoms. Okay, guys, the content is a more means what we call it more important part. If you give the content which is a copyright, or if you see this content are good in this website and you put it in your website, so it make the duplicate content and it's not allowed. Even if even your ranking is come down, so make sure you make your content which is unique for your website. So another is a community. WordPress favors communities and membership based website and does not require special knowledge like priority softwares or other tools that internet website designer may use. So here also the easy for you, the sharing ability. Sharing is easier than the even in the huge WordPress community. You have widgets for the social media, plugins, API, and everything you need to connect your social account with your website and share your content on a various platform. So guys, this means actually you get many plugins. I told you before. So here also you get the social share plugins. If you like some content or if you like the post, okay, then you click on the share, choose you which platform you want to share it, just click and it share easily. Because of this your post or your content or anything, it means it famous on the another means it's famous on the another platform also. So this is the best thing for the bloggers and also the who's selling the e-commerce thing like a product and other things. Okay, then next is the open source. Open source software is the software whose source code is available for modification or enhancement by anyone. As open source software, WordPress is being improved every day by the thousands of developers around the world. This has attracted developers to contribute new features to the platform. This developer has created a stream of new plugins that makes WordPress more convenient and useful every day. If there are functionality that you need for your website changes are the there is a plugin in a WordPress directory that you can do. And also guys, means open source is the best thing. Like a Java, we always means learn in your graduation, or if you learn the coding like a Java or Python or other thing, you always hear the open source. platform. So WordPress is open source. Here you miss a change, if you your coding knowledge is good or if your coding knowledge is advanced, then you change as per your requirements in a plugin or in a theme for you. Okay, there is a responsive. We all know that the responsiveness is more important. If you are a user, okay, and you see my website, if it is not responsive in a mobile view, so it looks something cheaper or it's not really looking good, and you just shut your the window and you go for the another website. So this happened because of the responsive. To make sure your website is always responsive for your user, and also for your if you're providing the services, so make sure it for the customers also, guys. So this is the CMS is the best choice if you want your website to adjust to this device. It is accessed from the provided your visitor with an unforgettable experience, whether the smartphone, tablet, desktop and computer. Also guys, the best thing of the WordPress is the WordPress provide you the responsiveness, and you don't need any coding for this, like other coding software needs. Here they directly provide you the responsive feature. So if you created any website here in the WordPress, it directly comes to the responsive. Okay, so let's see the other. It is the functionality. While the most HTML website builds including only the basic functionality, WordPress take the concept to a new level, offering themes and plugins that make it easy to customize your website and improve the user experience. When you sign up for the WordPress website, there is no limit to how you can utilize the variety of plugins and theme. With a range of modern and contemporary themes, almost everyone can build a site for any type of the business, including your e-commerce, your retailer company, your professional blogger, job listing, non-profit, small business, online communities. Okay, so you use all means you make this website for your all services. There is no limit for any services. So let's see the application programming interference, which is called the APIs. So social media network offers APIs. Also guys, the payment also offers the API. Okay, it is allowing to the integration of a third party services with user website. WordPress make available thousands of APIs, giving you the freedom to integrate outside resources into your website. And also the APIs is always unique for all the users. So next is this is the scalability. Okay, if you only need a fast loading functionality website in the beginning, things may change as your business is grow and being to the here. So web developer everywhere will be confirmed that the WordPress allows you to create your own website network fast and easy, saving time and resources. Okay, let's see the another. This is the support. So the WordPress community include thousands of technical and volunteer providing free advice and the support on various platform. All you need to do the post your question and you will receive the answer in a no time. So I'm already tell you there is a 1000 plus themes and 56,000 plus the plugins. So each plugin or each theme have their own support. So yeah, it is help you a lot and it's not waste your time. Also it's notified by your mail that they give the answer of your question. So this is the best thing. And let's see the last point, which is the speed and efficiency. As hard to believe as it may seem, WordPress allows you to build your website in a little as a single day, only require pictures and contents. Many may argue that there are other priority software options out there and some of them offer most of the above benefits, but none of them will offer all at once and none of them will rise to the value, flexibility and the efficiency of a WordPress. So guys, here are all the benefits of the WordPress. First thing, the installation video of each, means like WAMP, XAMPP, WAMP.net, which I also told you, and I'm showing here. So how we install the WordPress for the localhost, also how we install the WordPress for our subdomain, and the many more videos for the plugins, for the themes, and the many customization. Also we made our website, a simple website. Also I'm showing you how we create a e-commerce website, how we set up the payment gateway, and the many more things here we do for you. So make sure guys you subscribe my channel and always stay connected with me. It's a tech plugin, guys. Hey guys, if you like watching this video, then like us, subscribe to my channel, share my videos, and don't forget to press the bell icon for the new updates. Thank you.